Today I'm using the Nikon D810 with the Sigma 24-105, about $4,000 worth of gear.
I have the Pentax K200, which you can pick up on eBay for about $100 with the lens.
And we're going head to head, because Tony is saying that with a little bit of time, patience, and skill, he can get a more technically perfect picture, or equally perfect picture, as I can with the D810.
If you have money but no time, that's a good setup. But I bet if you have time and no money, you can get better results with this.
That's way suckier than I thought.
I did not expect the snow to be this deep.
So I'm going to be using a base ISO of 64 and using this lens's sweet spot for the aperture, which is f8. I'm done.
I'm at f8.2. My base ISO is ISO 100, so let's see how a quick snapshot compares.
Even at a glance, the D810's picture is far sharper. Zoom in tight and you really see what you get for that extra $3,900. Pull in even tighter on the sky and we see that the Pentax shows chunky noise in the blue sky and shadows, while the Nikon is much smoother. Crank up the brightness to really see the shadow noise, and again, the Nikon obviously wins.
Just ran out of batteries. So the shadow noise didn't quite keep up, but that's a pretty easy fix. Just gonna throw this on a tripod and take a bunch of pictures. I'm gonna use a technique called image averaging, which will pull all those images together and just basically gather far more light than I could in a single exposure. It's one of those times when live view would be helpful on this thing.
Yeah, I know.
If you have Lightroom in Photoshop, select all your pictures, right-click them, and then select Open as Layers in Photoshop. I took 27 pictures, but 4 to 8 pictures is usually enough. Once Photoshop loads the images, open the Select menu and then select All Layers. Now, open the Edit menu and select Auto Align Layers. The default is fine, click OK. This might take a minute to process. Now, open the Layer menu, select Smart Objects, and select Convert to Smart Object. When it's done, open the Layer menu, select Smart Objects, Stack Mode, and Mean. Now, I'll save and close the picture to bring it back into Lightroom. Here, you can see the averaged image has smooth clouds. That's because they were moving, and blending the image essentially creates a 30-second exposure. Yep, you can use image averaging to get the effect of a neutral density filter when you don't have one in your bag. Zooming in tight on the sky, we see that the averaged image has no visible noise in the sky. Cranking up the contrast makes the difference even more obvious. Looking at the shadow noise, the averaged image on the right is far cleaner than the single image on the left. Comparing the averaged image to the Nikon's, the averaged image from the Pentax is cleaner, but definitely not sharper. Now I know, Photoshop costs money and this is all about being cheap. Well, guess what? You can get all this done with the free GIMP tool. Also, Lightroom and Photoshop don't have to cost that much. In the US, you can get them for $9.99 a month bundled together. In GIMP, which you can download for free at gimp.org, open the File menu and select Open as Layers. Select all the pictures you want to stack by clicking the first picture and then shift-clicking the last picture. Now, manually adjust the opacity of the layers. The bottom layer should have an opacity of 100%. The second layer from the bottom should have an opacity of 50%, or 100 divided by 2. To determine the opacity of each layer, divide 100 by the layer number. So the third layer from the bottom has an opacity of 33%, because 100 divided by 3 equals 33. The fourth layer is 100 divided by 4, or 25. Repeat for each layer. Now, export your picture. On the File menu, select Export As, and then save your averaged image as a JPEG.
Relaxing on the beach.
Show off. So that helped a lot with the shadow noise, but it doesn't overcome that D810's 36 megapixel sensor, that super sharp lens. So to do that, I'm gonna make a panorama, but I'm gonna combine both these techniques. I'm gonna use a panorama, stitching together multiple telephoto pictures of this place, and use image averaging for each of those pictures. So each one will be low noise, and then I'll combine all those pictures to get a high megapixel photo. Just a little patience. For the panorama, I'm zooming up on a small section of the building, and then I'm gonna take a picture, or a bunch of pictures, so I can stack them, and then move a little bit to the right, take another picture, and a bunch of pictures, move to the right. So in total, I'm gonna do a bunch of pictures horizontally, and then three rows vertically, and stitch them all together in the computer. You don't want to change your exposure settings or refocus. This is one of those times when back button focus works really well. I just back button focus with the first picture, lock my settings in with manual, and then keep those throughout the shot. If you do screw it up though, the software pretty much fixes it for you. You want to overlap each one of your pictures by about one third or more left to right, as well as up and down.
If you want a more detailed picture, zoom in tighter so that you have to take more pictures.
I usually prefer a ball head, but a pan tilt head like this actually makes panoramas easier by allowing me to just move horizontally and vertically perfectly.
Don't feel like you have to line everything up perfectly. The software will straighten your pictures and fix any lens distortion. You can do this handheld too. Just be sure to hold perfectly still when taking pictures. You get the idea. Zoom in and snap lots of overlapping pictures until you've photographed every part of the scene, leaving plenty of room to crop on every side. I took 18 stacks of 6 pictures for a total of 108 photos. With unsharp images removed, I need to do the image averaging for each of the 18 stacks using the process I showed earlier. To speed it up a bit, I created a Photoshop action that you can download at sdp.io/actions. I threw in a bonus action for median stacking, which removes moving people from a stack of photos. I repeated that process for each of the 18 stacks and then exported the averaged pictures as high-quality JPEGs. Now, I'll use Microsoft ICE to combine the pictures into a panorama. It's a free download from sdp.io/ICE. It's Windows only, but you can find other panorama software for macOS, Linux, iOS, and Android. Just drag all the pictures into ICE, it puts them together for you. Click Next and zoom in to see your picture better. Now, pick the projection that looks best with your picture. Make sure the lines are straight and nothing looks too distorted. Dragging the picture up or down on the grid can change the projection and distortion too. Once you find a natural-looking projection, click Next to move to step 3, crop. Now, you'll see why I recommended you take extra pictures and shoot wider than necessary. You'll end up clipping a good part of your picture out. When you're done cropping, click Next to move to the final step. Export your picture as a TIFF for best quality, or as a JPEG if you want to share it right away. Let's find out whether that work paid off. I gave Chelsea a blind test during our weekly live broadcast.
This is going to be a blind test, so you just tell me which of these pictures you think is technically better, which is sharper.
They actually both look almost the same. Maybe the one on the right is a hair sharper? Yeah, the one on the right is sharper. That is the Pentax?
That's the Pentax. I won in your face.
Yes,
you said it couldn't be done?
No,
you with your
I didn't.
Fancy camera?
No, I never said that, but I will say this. I just walked up and was like, look, and then walked away, and you were there for 10 minutes. And I got to lounge on the beach. I thought about life. I planned my retirement. Like, you were still there taking that picture.
Yeah, and that was actually the point I was trying to make is, in photography, often the expensive gear is just a matter of saving
time?
You time. Mm. So the D810 takes a great picture in a second, and it took me like 15 minutes at the beach and then an hour in post-processing at least to stitch together this panorama. But the same holds true for wildlife photography. Like, you could get a big 600mm f4 lens for $15,000 and it would bring you closer to the birds, or you could get a cheap lens and hide in the bushes and spend a few more hours out there.
Or you could spend
and take a few thousand more pictures
befriending the birds.
I just also wanted to show off, not only did I get more detail out of it, but I got cleaner noise, like less noise. I basically just looked you.
I
totally looked you.
I don't feel that way, but I'm glad you do, because you really suffered picking it.
As you saw, I made it a blind test. You picked your cell phone for YouTube. So who knows?
I did pick my YouTube.